If you would like to learn Arabic alphabets, then we have to define the alphabet in the initial form and in the medial form and in the final position. So we have three positions. Yeah. And you can find a lot of alphabets that probably could be connected in the initial position, in the medial position, but maybe disconnected in the final position. Let me just give you an example here. Can you see that? Ab. Yeah. Father. Can you see that?
Yeah.
So you see here that the ba is disconnected.
Yeah,
it's not connected with the previous letter.
Yeah.
But if you say, for example, bab, can you see ba here? It's connected.
Yeah.
It comes in the initial position of the word and it's connected. But sometimes it comes disconnected when it comes, for example, in the final position here.
Yeah.
So something like that probably could be considered also as a characteristic of the Arabic language. Any more questions, please? Okay. Yep. Okay. Now let's move on here to another slide that we have here today. Characteristics of Arabic pronunciation.
Yeah, please. Yep. I do have a question.
Yep. Go ahead, Osama.
Yeah, as you know, the English language or differences of accent in the English language are mainly due to the differences in the pronunciation of vowels.
Yeah.
But
true.
Consonants are spoken or are pronounced the same way whenever English is spoken.
Okay.
So what about Arabic concerning this
issue? Oh, Osama, you touched a very sensitive nerve here. Because actually one of the major differences between Arabic and English is the style of vowels. And actually you can find in Arabic a lot of consonants that probably can be similar to the consonants in English. Let me just give you an example. You can find the alphabet ta.
Yeah.
Alif. Ba, ta. So this is ta as the alphabet. But when you pronounce it, we say ta. And of course, there is a difference between the alphabet as a letter and as a sound.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, does this sound also available in English? Yep. It's found in English.
Yeah.
We have A, B, C, S, T. T. We have T. It's very close, actually, to T in English, right? Yes. But on the other hand, you can find, for example, some letters in Arabic that may not be available in English. But, very important point here that I have to explain to all of you. The variations of the vowels in Arabic probably reflects where are you from.
Yeah.
Yep. So for example, you can find in the Gulf area, in the Gulf countries, they pronounce the first alphabet, which is Alif, which pronounced A. Sometimes they pronounce it as A. So they say for father, Al-Walid. But here in Egypt, for example, we say Al-Walid. So actually, the variation, the differences in producing the vowel probably reflects the place where you are coming from.
Yeah.
Here we go. But when it comes to consonants, I think that consonants, all of them have to be pronounced in the same way, in the same form.
Yeah.
So we don't have any variations when it comes to consonants. We do have variation just in vowels. And actually, as everyone knows, that in English, for example, you can find short vowels. We have, again, also the long vowels.
Yeah.
We
have diphthongs also.
Right. In Arabic also, we do have the same. Because a lot of linguists said before that in Arabic, we don't have vowels. That is not true.
Yeah.
In Arabic also, we have short vowels, and we do have also long vowels.
Yeah.
Probably also we have diphthongs or gemination, as we can discuss this point later.
Yeah.
But back to your question, Sam, I think in such a way, you can find variation in vowels, but not variations in consonants. You can find differences in vowels, and such difference actually reflects where are you coming from.
Okay. So, please, Ahmed.
Yep.
In learning English,
yep.
I have dictionaries
yep.
that tells me the pronunciation, how to pronounce such a word.
Yep.
Are there any dictionaries for pronouncing or for the transcription of the Arabic letters?
Interesting. I think, yes, we do have. And that's called, actually, transliteration for the Arabic alphabets.
Yeah.
And you can find it depends on the dictionary. As you have in English, for example, you have transcription for the words in English.
Yeah.
And it depends also on the style of transcription that can be found in English dictionaries. It's also the same that can be found in Arabic. So in Arabic, we do have transliteration for the Arabic alphabets. All the letters in Arabic alphabets, actually, we can find transliteration in different Arabic dictionaries. It's something that should be available. And I think you can find that probably in the first pages of any dictionary in Arabic language.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks.
Any more question?
Oh, thanks.
Okay, let's move on here. Now, we were talking about the characteristics of writing in Arabic. And that's probably, as you can see, that the writing system in Arabic It's very distinctive. But when it comes to the characteristics of Arabic pronunciation, I think also we can find a lot of distinctive features that probably distinguish Arabic from other different languages.